Well, good morning, church family. It is Monday morning, April the 6th, and I am very honored to be with you this morning and almost excited about what God has laid on me this morning just to do our little devotional. And it comes out of probably one of the most recognizable verses of Scripture that talks about do not be afraid. And it's Joshua chapter 1. 1 through basically 9, but I'm just going to read a couple of those verses. But before we get into that, I want to tell you, usually whenever I talk about this passage or teach from this passage, it has to do with stepping out in faith and stepping into God's faithfulness. So basically it's about us, whenever I've taught it before, is about us stepping out into faith, or stepping out with faith into God's faithfulness, basically stepping into His faithfulness and seeing what He does because of who He is. And the scripture that we're about to look at, it really kind of gives us a picture of doing that. But today, the underlying truth that we're going to talk about really applies to our situation here. And it may really resonate with you this morning because of where you are in the situation where you, are in right now. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to jump into it. In Joshua chapter 1, Moses just died. He passed away, and the second in command, his assistant, was Joshua. And so basically it's Joshua's turn to lead the Israelites. Now, if you know anything about where they are, God promised Abram the promised land, and Moses led him all the way up to the promised land. Moses never went into the promised land. He saw it, but he never went into it. And then he passed away, and then God comes to Joshua and says, Joshua, it's your turn to lead. Now, take the Israelites, you and my children, go into the promised land. Take over the promised land. I will give you every place that you put your foot on. Just take it over. It is yours for the taking. Now imagine that. Joshua, brand new, leading Israel. He was always under Moses, but now it's his turn. And God says, hey, you take the children of Israelites into the promised land. It's your job now, buddy. Run with it. And then we're going to pick up where he's talking to Joshua. He says a couple of God says a couple of things of be strong and courageous, be strong and courageous. And then we're going to pick up in verse 8, and it says this. This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do according to all that is written in it. For then you will make your way prosperous, and then you will be good, you'll have good success. Have I not commanded you? Now here's our verse, here's our little phrase. Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid, and do not be dismayed. For the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Now there's so much in here. I may be in this for a couple of days, but today what I want you to understand is this, is God is saying, and who God is, after reading this over and over again, God is basically saying, do not be afraid. Do not be dismayed, which basically means do not be distressed. Do not be disheartened. Do not be distressed in what's going on, because, and this is the truth, this is the underlying truth, God is our strength. In 2 Corinthians, it says in weakness, my strength is made perfect. And I want you to understand that God is our strength. And today, no matter what situation you're in, what circumstances this has been in your life, God is your strength. God is my strength. And today I want to encourage you to lean into His strength. What that looks like, I'm not quite sure, but just understand that we can't control the situation, but what we can do is we can rely on, lean into, step into God's strength, step into His faithfulness, and we can rely on God's strength because God is our strength. He is your strength today. So whatever you're going through, God is your strength. I want to pray that over you, and I want you to be encouraged by that. He is your strength. And in your weakness and in my weakness, according to the scriptures, his strength is made perfect. And praise the Lord for that. So I'm just praying for you guys today. I want to be thankful today for our teachers. Our teachers are trying to learn something new, this whole thing. They're trying to learn, you know, digital online teaching, just different things like that. So I want to be thankful for our teachers today. I have a heart full of gratefulness and gratitude for our teachers today. I want to pray for them, lift them up. But also my prayer request today is for all the families that have lost loved ones during this time, not just to the COVID virus or anything like that, but just lost loved ones during this time because they haven't been able to be with the loved ones, or maybe it is because of the virus. But I just want to pray for those families today. So I'm going to ask you to join me in prayer, being grateful for our teachers who are doing an amazing job if they're still having to teach online, and then also praying for the families. And while I'm doing that, I want you to know that I am praying for you as well, to rely and to lean in God's strength. Let's pray. God, I thank you for your son, Jesus. I thank you for the grace and mercy that comes through him. And God, right now, I want to praise your name for our teachers that are trying to learn something new at the same time as trying to do their job and trying to lead their classes. So Lord, I'm praying for them. I'm thanking you for them. Lord, I'm thanking you for their heart and their desire to teach and their desire to shape children and influence children. And so God, I just want to pray for them and thank you for them. And God, now my heart really does go out to those that are aching because they've lost loved ones, or maybe they're about to lose loved ones during this time. God, whether it's to the virus or not to the virus, Lord, I just want to pray for those families right now. God, I pray that they would run to you with every and all questions that they have, God, that they would run to you and ask you the questions and bring their concerns to you. And God, that you would be their strength during this time, that you would be able to comfort them during this time, and that they would come to know your son, Jesus, as their personal Savior. That's my prayer, Father. And in Jesus' name I pray, amen. Well, I'm praying for you today, church family. I miss you. I love you. I'm excited to be with you today like this, but man, I can't wait to see you in person. And just remember that God is our strength. Lean in him, step into his faithfulness. Whatever situation you have to do today, step into his faithfulness. And always remember, turn down the media, the volume of the media, and turn up the truth of God's word. Always turn up the truth of God's word. And in Christ Jesus, there is always hope. I pray that you have that today. God bless you guys. Have a great day.